Good morning.
Good morning.
I got to laugh. I'm going to be honest with you right up front. Pastor Dan's on vacation, and as always, he talked to me and he said, "Hey, would you be willing to fill in for me?" Absolutely. Anytime I can bring God's word to his people, I'll take the chance of that. And then I told Dan, I said, "You know, if you'd go away more often, I'd really appreciate it." I'm going to tell you right now, this entire sermon came from that comment. And take God's word into all the world. What I meant, Dan, was, love you to death, you're an excellent preacher, but when you go on vacation, not only do you get to have a vacation, but I get to preach. But that's not the way it came out. The way it came out was, go away, man, I want you to go away. And we were laughing about that a little bit, but I got to think about that. You know, if I'm taking God's word out into the world, is it coming across the way God wants it to come across? Taking God's word into all the world. I'm going to open with the word prayer. And part of my prayer is going to be that God will help me say what he once said, not what I once said. Let's pray. Father, we thank you for this opportunity you've given us to come here, to be able to be here in your house with your people, and to just be able to draw closer unto you, to learn more about you, and be able to just glorify you. And Lord, I ask that you be with me now, that I will not in any way hinder anything you once said. I will not get in your way. I will not in any way change what you're trying to do here. I just ask that you just push me aside, Lord, and help us to hear what you want us to hear, to be able to grow and be able to learn and draw closer unto you. These saints, I pray in Jesus' name, amen. And I'm going to start off with my... Did the sun come out? Okay, I would say it's brighter than it was when I closed my eyes. I'm going to start off with my favorite verse. I got to start right off with that. We're going to just go from there and see where God leads us. Matthew 28:18-20. Then Jesus came to them and said, and of course he's speaking to his disciples, "All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me, therefore go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything I have commanded you. And surely I am with you always to the very end of the age." I like that. And I try my best to live on that. And I ask myself this question. One, God, why would you want me to preach? I'm a technician. I'm not a pastor. Why do you want me to preach? Dan's the pastor. And you know, when you read this, go into all the world, he's not talking to pastors. He's talking to each and every one of us. I am to go into all the world as a technician. He is to go into all the world as a pastor. Whether you're a mechanic, whether you're a fireman, whether you're a school teacher, whether you're a police officer, God is expecting us to go into all the world. Okay, I'll buy that. I was listening to Tony Evans this last week. And I realized something that I had not realized. And I stepped back through some of my old sermons and I said, you know what? I see it. Dan's a pastor. Dan will teach you the word of God. Dan will inspire you. Dan will lead you. I'm a technician. I trust you. What's wrong? Why isn't it working? I will compare. This one's broke. This one works. What is this one doing? This one's not doing. And you know, the scariest thing I run into is when I find out there are two sides to the keyboard. Is it on this side where the equipment's not functioning? Is it on this side where the user's malfunctioning? Do you know how hard it is to fix a user? If I go into a 911 center and I have to explain to a dispatcher. The equipment works just fine. That's tough. That's tough to do. You don't just go blowing in there and say, "You vacuum drain, that's not the way it works." Yeah, that doesn't go over well. And I'm thinking the same thing when I was talking to Dan. It doesn't go over well when I come up and say, "Dan, you need to go away more often." I'm thinking that, like, how can I help do the job God wants me to do to go into all the world? And the first thing I'm learning is God is not asking me to quit my job, leave my wife, take what money I have, and go overseas into foreign countries and spread his gospel. I can't speak their language. I would have no idea how to get there. I don't have the financial backing to do that. And I'm not leaving my wife, at least I would really prefer not to. And God has blessed me with a good job. Why do you want to change all that? So I start looking at that verse. And teach them to obey everything I have commanded you. Okay? Who do you want me to teach, Lord? Well, I put you in somewhere. Let's start there. Okay? My part of the world, I'll teach in Sunbury. Every day I drive to Columbus. Maybe I should teach in Columbus. Some days I go to Delaware. Some days I go to Newark. I need to take God's word into those places. Okay? Again, I'm a technician. I need to figure out exactly what does it take to make this happen. I started in reading John. Just the basic, right off. John 1. That is the first five verses. In the beginning was the Word. The Word was with God. The Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. Through Him, all things were made. Without Him, nothing was made that has been made. In Him was life. And that life was the light of men. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not understood it. Jumping down to verse 14. And that Word became flesh and made His dwelling among us. We have seen His glory, the glory of the one and only who came from the Father, full of grace and truth. So we know the Word of God is the Lord Jesus Christ. I am to take Jesus into the world. Every place I go, I am to take Jesus with me. And teach them to obey everything I have commanded you. Everything I have commanded you. What have you commanded me? What have you commanded me? Exodus. Chapter 20, verses 1 to 6. God spoke these words. I am the Lord your God, who brought you out of Egypt, out of the land of slavery. You shall have no other gods before me. You shall not make for yourself an idol in the form of anything in heaven above, or on earth beneath, or the waters below. You shall not bow down to them or worship them, for I, the Lord, your God, am a jealous God, punishing the children for the sins of the fathers to the third and fourth generation of those who hate me. But, you remember when I preach, but the important thing that he's trying to say comes after that word, showing love. Showing love to 1,000, not 3, not 4, but 1,000 generations to those who love me and keep my commands. How do I take the Lord Jesus Christ into the world where God sends me on a day-to-day basis? I have to show love. I have to show love. If we look at Matthew chapter 22, and we read verses 36 to 39, we will read Jesus' interpretation. what God said in those commandments. Jesus interprets those as this. Which of these are the greatest commandments of the law? Jesus replies, love. Love the Lord your God with all of your heart, with all of your soul, and with all of your mind. This is the first and the greatest commandment. The second one is just like love. Love your neighbor as yourself. Jesus' interpretation of that first commandment, showing love to 1,000 generations, to those who love me and keep my commandments. I'm going to throw a side note in here. Don't confuse what I just did. If you read Exodus and the first 6 verses, that's actually 2 commandments. Love the Lord your God and do not have any idols. I kind of read that all as one great big commandment. It is 2 commandments. Love the Lord your God and do not have any idols before him. 1 and 2. Just wanted to clarify that. So I look at this, and again, from a technician point of view, how do I make it work? How do I make it work? I'm going to drive down 71, and I'm going to go to Columbus, and there's going to be people all around me. I need to show them love. How do I do that? How do I show people I cannot talk to? Love. That first word, love. Love the Lord your God. How do I do that? 1 Corinthians. We can probably quote it together with our Bibles open. 1 Corinthians 13, 4 through 8, love. Love is patient. Love is kind. Love does not envy. Love does not boast. It is not proud. It is not rude. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. Does not say it is not angry. It says it's not easily angry. It keeps no records of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. Love never fails. See, part of those right there describe how I am to love when God sends me to Columbus down Route 71. I'm to be patient while I'm driving down through that middle section of the highway. Patient does not mean driving 35 mile an hour in a 70 mile an hour speed zone. It might mean not driving 70 in the far left lane. You know, I might want to keep over to the right. Be kind. Love is kind. I can be kind to people. Between here and Columbus, I'm going to have about 30 places where people are changing lanes on a Polaris, off a Polaris, on a 270, off a 270. I can be kind and back up for a little bit and let people over when they need to be. But you know, when I'm reading this, envy, boast, is not proud. We got a service call a couple weeks ago where the military base, it's DSCC, I don't know that it's a military base, but it is all military. They had called us and asked us to come in and work on one of the radios. That's a little bit rare. They maintain their own systems, but they called. My boss got a little radio, so I went over there. I go over and I get onto the base and I go into their dispatch center. Their radio that links them to the city of Columbus was dead. I'm talking with a technician who does the service work, and he's explaining what he's going through to fix this radio. He's done everything perfect. Dispatchers are in this room. Of course, I have their attention now. The dispatch supervisor's in the room. This man's boss is in this room. This guy's in this room, and I'm in this room. As I walk over to the radio and I hit the power button, the radio lights up, immediately comes to light, falls on, and Columbus starts talking. And I'm thinking, not good. So immediately I stop and I'm thinking, okay, man, so this is going to be tough. So do you have your test equipment stuff you were telling me about? He's like, yeah, sure do. This is going to be tough because now we've got to figure out what's in the net and not just radio. Because obviously it wouldn't come on earlier. Now it came on. That's going to be hard to find. And we spent probably an hour going through this radio, making sure the connectors were tight, until finally I could get the dispatchers to do their job. Supervisor had walked away. It was just the two of us, and I told him, Motorola radio, turn it down, it goes off. Turn it on, up, it comes on. It says that Johnson hit the button. And he's like, are you serious? He was trying to turn it on. He wasn't hitting the power button. That's all it was. But you know, I could have gone in there and said, yeah, man, you got to learn how to run the equipment, hit the power button. That would have done absolutely no good whatsoever. That would have done no good. And so I'm looking at this, I'm saying, does not boast, is not proud. I'm not going in there to try to say, look, me, I'm the greatest. No, I'm there for one purpose. Get the gentleman what he needed, and I did. And I helped him learn the difference between different models of radios. I helped him, I encouraged him. Nobody got in any hot water. Love. See, God expects that kind of attitude. Did I ever lie? No. I never lied to anybody about what we did. We did find some loose connection. We did do some work. I never lied about anything. I just didn't advertise what was wrong with the radio. Love is patient, and love is kind. It does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. It's not rude. It's not self-seeking. It's not easily angry. And it keeps no wrong, you know, records of wrongs, does not delight in evil, but rejoices in the truth. It always protects. It always trusts. It always hopes. It always perseveres. Love will never fail. The verse that Jesus read, love the Lord your God with all of your heart. With all of your heart. How do I love somebody? With all of my heart. I think about that. I think Carl and I met August of 68. I've only dated one person my entire life. Do I love Carl? I don't plant flowers. But I'll go out with Carl, I'll plant flowers. How is it that Carl can get me to go out with her and plant flowers and enjoy that? Because I love her. Why do we not jump on an airplane and fly to Colorado? Because we have 3 days that we take to drive to Colorado, because we spend that time together, because we enjoy that time together. I love God with all my heart. Do I love God in the same way? Will I just stop what I'm doing if God says go take flowers? If God says I want you to take a 3-day trip, I know you can get there quicker by plane, but I want you to drive. Do I do that? What do I do when God says do things? Colossians 3, starting with verse 18. Wives, submit to your husbands as it is fitting in the Lord. Husbands, love your wives and do not be harsh to them. Children, obey your parents in everything, for this pleases the Lord. Fathers, do not embitter your children, or they will become discouraged. Slaves, obey your earthly master. Let's back up. Employees, obey your boss in everything, and do it not only when their eye is on you and to win their favor, but with sincerity of heart and reverence for the Lord. Whatever you do, whatever, wives, whatever, husbands, whatever, children, whatever, employees, whatever you do, work at it with all of your heart as working for the Lord, not for men. Since you know that you will receive an inheritance from the Lord as a reward, it is the Lord Christ your servant. How do I drive down 71 and walk into a dispatch center and explain to an operator that the mistake is their mistake, not the equipment? I do it with the love of God. I do not go in there saying, I know how to work this, you need to listen to me. I go in and I say, Here's what it should do. When it doesn't do this, this is what you need to change. And I very lovingly and caringly explain what God has called me to do as a technician. When you keep reading in there, with all of your soul, with all of your soul, love the Lord your God, with all of your heart, with all of your soul, the very essence of who I am, how do I love the Lord with himself? Flip back into the Old Testament. I went into Deuteronomy 13, 5 verses. If a prophet or one who foretells my dreams appears among you and announces to you a miraculous sign or a wonder, and if that sign or wonder of which he has spoken takes place, and then he says, let us follow other gods. Gods you have not known. Let us worship them. You must not listen to the words of that prophet or that dreamer. The Lord your God is testing you to find out whether you love him with all of your heart and with all of your soul. It is the Lord your God you must follow, and him you must revere. Keep his commandments and obey him. Serve him and hold fast to him with all your soul, everything that God has made you. You must keep his commands, obey him, serve him, and hold fast to him. And you know, it also says, with all of your mind, with all of your mind. If you look at the front of your bulletin, you see the trend. Nobody is probably surprised by the fact that when I preach, they put a trend on the front of the bulletin. I am probably one of the very few people that can stand outside and listen to a train horn and tell you how many horsepower is in the engine is pulling. Because there are a different number of tones in the whistle, in the horn on the engine. The more tones, the more horsepower. I can listen to a car rolling down the rail and tell you if that car has ever been had the brakes locked up on it, because they'll have a flat spot on the wheels and you'll hear it. There's a flat spot on the wheels. I can look at train cars and tell you what they're designed to do, what kind of stuff they're hauling in, and I can tell you whether they're full or empty. Can I tell you that much about God? Can I listen to the Word of God and explain to you what it means and what's going on? Can I look at the world around me and explain what God is doing? Do I know as much about God as I do about trains? With all of my mind, I am to love the Lord with all of my mind. Philippians 4. Starting in verse 4, rejoice in the Lord always. I'll say it again, rejoice. Rejoice, let your gentleness be evident to all. The Lord is near. Do not be anxious about anything, but in everything, by prayer and petition with thanksgiving, present your request to God and the peace. The peace which transcends all understanding will guard your heart and your mind in Christ Jesus. Finally, brothers, whatever is true, whatever is noble, whatever is right, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is admirable, if anything is excellent or praiseworthy, think with your mind. Think about such things. Whatever you have learned, whatever you have received or heard from me or seen in me, put it into practice. For the God of peace will be with you. All of your mind. Jesus says, love the Lord your God, with all of your heart, with all of your soul, and with all of your mind. The first and greatest commandment. And the second one is just like, love your neighbor as yourself. And God said back in the Ten Commandments, I will show love to 1,000 generations for those who do exactly that, for those who love me and keep my commandments. See, I can drive down that highway to Columbus. I can be just as mean and nasty as the people around me. Or I can show love. How do I take the Word of God into all the world? How do I take the Lord Jesus Christ into all the world? I take Him every single place that God sends me. Whether it be into a dispatch center or it be up into a tower 800 foot up in the air. And trust me, when you're 800 foot up on the side of a tower, you're a lot closer to God than you are when you're standing on the ground because you're in constant prayer. But you know, when I'm driving down that highway, I can be kind. I can be an example of what God has called me to be. I can be the man that God wants me to be. I am a technician. I'm a technician, and so what do? I troubleshoot. So when I stop and I say, what's wrong here? Why am I not able to show these people or take God into, you know, this world? I need to back up and say it's because I'm doing something wrong, because God's equipment never fails. The problem's on the other side of the keyboard. What am I doing wrong? Am I showing others kindness? Am I sharing the love of Lord Jesus with them in my actions? Okay, it's been over 3 years. Ready? What did I tell you the word for the day was? That was 3 years ago. Does anybody remember what that was? I taught you a term. Does anybody other than Kelly, who happens to be back here, know what that term was? What was the term, remember? That's exactly what it was. There you go. What did I hold in my hand? True. See, I can teach you all day long, and chances are you're going to remember. I can do my best to explain, and one or two people will remember. But if I show you, 3 years ago I had a little tree in my hand. Most everybody remembered that tree. I don't need to talk to the people on 71. I need to show the people on 71. I need to show them the love of the Lord Jesus Christ, how to be patient, how to be kind, how to drive with love, and let them see. They'll remember that. So see, this now is your time. This is now your time. Do not misunderstand what I'm saying. I am not under any circumstances trying to say, you need to do this. You need to do this. No. I need to do this. This is what God has said to me. If you do not know the Lord Jesus Christ, I would be very excited to introduce you to Him. And here is the test I give me. If I'm going to try to drive down that highway to show people the love of the Lord Jesus Christ, am I really going to do it? Am I willing to step out of my seat, walk up here, and pray to God for the strength to do His hand? If I am not willing to get out of my seat and pray for God's strength, then chances are I'm also not going to share Jesus going down that highway. That's something I troubleshoot as a technician in my own heart. I test myself. Am I willing to get out of my seat and ask for prayer, for strength to take God into the world, or not? Because I know me, and if I'm say, yes, Lord. Yes, I'm coming forward. I'm going to pray. Whether I pray by myself, which you're not praying by yourself, because everybody else is praying for you also. Whether you talk to me or not,